All right, someone. I've fixed all of the remaining bugs that I could find, including the ones I mentioned in the last video. I've done a detailed pass of this area here so that when the player's standing here, it doesn't look too much like the map that it was taken from, which was New Job. So I've gone back to the original cobblestone section, which is what I started doing on the outside of this map. Used my own drains, which are actual proper drains as opposed to a model that sits over the top. I've mucked about with a few other things around to obviously change the bits that I've grabbed from New Job, and then obviously just customize them to make them look sufficiently different. So I, from here looking down, should be different enough hopefully. That's a square from round the back. It's smaller than it was before. I've removed the tree and all the stuff that was there. Put a well in there, so that should look sufficiently different. In fact, that whole module there, for example, that's a prefab. Skins. So basically what we're going to do, as you can see here, every roof has the same skin texture on it, which can get a bit boring. So I've been thinking about this for 2 days, and other stuff's been happening that's precluded me from doing this. So the first thing that popped into my mind is obviously we already have existing skins for these roof modules. So what I'm gonna have to do is find the skins for these modules that already exist. Excuse me. And then add different roof textures while also retaining all the original options, like their tan, or there it's mixed brick, or there we have old plaster, there we have red bricks, I think they're called. There we have wooden boards. What else? Old plaster again. Mixed round, I don't know what they're called. Old boards again. Old plaster. And that there, I forget what that one's called. But basically, we need to retain those and can't overwrite those. I still need those options. So, going to the old sorry, the existing games folder. There's a PK4 in here that has all the skins in them. I think it's called models decals. There you go, they're all the different skins. Now, as I have access to the SVN, I don't need to go and unpack it. I can just go into the skins folder and get the one out I want. Now, I'm fairly sure it's going to be one of these two that Spring Hill created. So let's just open one. My weapon of choice is Notepad +++. There you can see I was making, or you looking. This is where I'm me. There you go. I added some new skins for basically new lights that I added. Or sorry, existing models even. That lamp there didn't have. It wasn't very tall for this map, so I had to try and retain the height of the lamp I had in there. I had a three-way lamp, and the base is a separate model. Add that, but it was all in black or rusted. It didn't have a matching skin. So to make that skin there, the way you look at an existing model and figure out what texture you want to change is there. TDM street lamp metal. So there's, where is it? There we go. So in this case, I've made a lit one and an unlit one. So you took skin, give it the skin a name. I like to be very literal, what it relates to, but you don't have to. You could have called it just iron dark lit, for example. It's up to you how you want to do your skins. I try to stay as close to TDM nomenclature, if that's the right word, as possible. So there's the original texture. And there's the one we want to replace it with. That's the swapping around the textures, and that's what gives me, or us, I should say, that texture on that model. Now, the thing to be aware of is when you do these skins, not all textures are going to stretch and fit properly. In this instance, that texture, it looks a bit weird in DR, but in game, it's fantastic. It's like it's almost perfectly suited to that lamp. So, like for example, when I did all of these internal textures for the internal modules, there was still some textures in there I couldn't use because the scaling's all wrong. So the thing to do there would be to make up a new texture using the existing texture files, change the scaling, or I think probably a cheat would be to create a material definition where you increase the scale. So you can increase it in both X and Y, but that's another story entirely, and we can do that in another video. Right, for now, we're going to be doing these roof textures. Right, so first things first, let's find all our different modules. So there's 128s, there's 256s, and there's spacers as well. They need to be changed. Now, what you could do if there wasn't an existing skin for these is like I just did a second ago, choose model, and the texture I want to change is there, that one. But as there's already a bunch of textures, a bunch of skins for this already, we need to retain all of those. So basically what we're going to have once we've created them all is dirty plaster opaque 2, dirty plaster, sorry, dull and lit 02, and then we're going to have different texture, different roof textures under that. Now, I'm not going to spend all day putting every roof texture we've got into this list. What I'm just going to create is a variation. So let's have a look at some roof textures. I'm thinking 4 different roof textures should be enough. All right, so there's the existing one. So what we want is something detailed as that. That's too boring. And I don't know what there is a good texture. It's got some nice detail in it. Boring, 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 boring. Still boring. There's another one. It's probably a bit dark though. Ah, there's a good one. The other thing I'm looking at, only because I've done this skinning thing a few times, I'm looking for textures that are at the same scale. I think I alluded to that when I was talking about the internal modules. I tried some wallpaper textures and they just didn't scale properly on the models, so you'd have to create new textures. So in this instance, what the easy way around that to make sure the textures I end up putting on all these roofs scale nicely is to get ones that look like they're in the same scale. Like that one, for example, that's of a similar scale, but it's not very detailed. That one, too, the slates are far too big, so I can't use that. Yeah, that one you could get away with. That one is perfect. Let's grab the steel one because of, in absence of that, I'm trying to find 4 good ones. Too dark. Yeah, we've already grabbed that one. It's a shame because that's a good roof texture. It's just the scale is wrong. Wrong as in it's not right for what we're going to be doing with it. And that's too small. And that's too expensive for this area. I guess it'll have to be that one then. We've not already got it. Right, there we go. So there's our 4 roof textures that we're going to be using. Right, next thing. Find the model. So go into here. In fact, let me think about this because I can use a lot of the work that Springs has already done rather than creating a load of stuff. This looks like all the interior stuff. Exterior stone set. So I think he may have done. There we go. Exterior timber set. Happy days. Now you can see some skins there, look, apply to loads of models. Base War, I think they're ones I added before I stopped being a team member. Yeah. Oh man, there's loads of bloody textures. Think this is this whole section is massive because it's probably the one that springs the most work on. Yep. This is gonna take a while. In fact, rather than copying all of this, because there's still, oh hang on, no, I probably will have to do it because I realized I've used a lot of LOD models. There, all the green ones are LOD models. So I could spend time noting down all of the models I've got, or we can just create new versions or additional versions of all the existing ones already. All right, there we go. And I'm going to give this a name so we don't overwrite all the existing texture, the existing skin definition. So, like all the other ones you've probably seen in there already, it's just got my BKD, obviously as an acronym for my alias on the forum, but it's easier that way because then you don't overwrite or you don't cause conflicts with existing skin definitions. And the same thing applies to material definitions, sound definitions. If you're going to create ones that are based off, you know, copied directly from stock, when you're saving them into your own FM, do that. So in your one, someone stole it, so it'll be S1I, I guess, or however you want to do your acronym. So, or S1, for example, someone, and then so someone underscore nature, etc., etc. So in this case, this is going to be a new one. I don't want to. It's easier to have, you can have one file, you could call it cleaning.skin and put everything in those, but it's nice when you want to go through and figure out which, rather than scrolling through a one ginormous skin definition, you can create ones for the different things that it does. As you can see there, nature, lights, furniture, architecture, which I think was the internal one, so this one is now going to be the outside. Right, so I think the first thing we'll do is I copy all of those. No, it doesn't look like I did. Right. So what we're going to do for each skin definition in this instance, I am going to add another texture swap entry and for each one. So in this instance it would be, where is it, slate uneven wood moss. That's the texture that we want to replace on all of our texture modules. So what I'll do is, in fact there's an easier way around this. You can see there what I'm doing, and this is going to be our, that will dump into the end of each skin. First of all, I'm going to get rid of all the ones that we don't, that aren't roofs. Fiddlesticks. That's the problem when you do when you make a lot of skins. That I know there is a. Oh no, it's a face only though. But there's a bunch of roofs. So even that, yeah, so there's a single skin there. Where I've done skins, I've named them after, but I suppose this is actually a more efficient way of doing it. You create one skin definition for multiple modules. All right, we're just gonna have to do this the hard way then, which is basically looking at each skin definition. And there's not like there, for example, there's no point applying it to that because that's literally a wall skin definition for wall modules. So no point doing anything there. Wall there, wall there, wall there, wall there. Right, there we go. There's one that has some roof modules on it. Blam. New definition. New, sorry, new definition, is that the right word? Oh, fiddlesticks. Yeah, you've got to have the space, otherwise it won't work. Right, this is pretty much it. There's nothing else beyond what I'm doing. If you wanted to introduce new modules, sorry, modules, models, you'd add them. You'd have model space, then the full path of the model to add it into your skin definition. That's it, really. That's all there is. As long as you've got an existing texture, you know what it is, and the way to do it is, like I say, is go in there or go into the module. Module, I keep saying that. It is a module, but it's a model. There's the thing I'm referring to. And just find the texture you want to swap. Like here, for example, Spring Hill would have replaced the texture on the front there, which in that one case there is dirty plaster. Now there's already a skin definition for that. It's obviously being smart with the texture usage. I use no shadow textures in areas where there's no point in it casting a shadow because that just eats up performance. And the other good thing about this, if you become a team member and or contribute to SVN, if you get used to working with, get used to working in or with TDM defaults, for want of a better description, i.e., you do the skins, use the exact pathing, everything, don't do. It's a good habit to get into. Good work in practice, I think, is the best way I can say that. Yeah, got more roofs there. And the benefit of the good work in practice and the bit that I was saying about becoming a team member or SVN access is, or even if you don't become a team member or don't have SVN access, team members moving forward can take the skins that I've just made here and dump the changes straight into the mod. So that these new textures that I'm these new skins I'm creating can become part of the core mod. Right, nearly done. If I've done it right. We'll have some nice fancy textures for us to use. Now the other thing there, you've probably noticed, Springs has put spaces in between them. It's sort of like shorthand, mapper shorthand when you're creating stuff like this. All of these windows, all of these modules, I think, are all very similar. They're all part of the same module set. So I think that's why he's grouped them like that. It's certainly why when I create skins, why I do that. So it's just easy when you're going through, going, oh, why is that skin working? Oh, bugger, I haven't added Timber 01 window empty or window 02 or window 03. In fact, me personally, I'd have get rid of all of those spaces, all the window ones I'd have together. fact, they're all windows. So yeah, all window, and that's a door. Those are extenders. So all the windows are together. Doors. So you can see where I'm going with that. Right now, I need to copy my selection back. Hope it makes sense. I know I'm not firing on all cylinders today. In fact, I've been adding it to places that I don't need to add it to. Possibly, but roof 128 is a roof module. So, got to be done. And those are just windows. Right, done. Now, if we reload skins. Woohoo! Although, it shouldn't have changed the default skin. So, I don't know what the hell happened there. I should say it shouldn't have changed the I've done something because it shouldn't have changed the I've done something wrong. The front face texture is changing but the roof texture isn't changing. Right, let's look at the last one. Formatting on some of these skins, there's a lot to be desired. Yeah, I'm fairly sure I've done that right. So there's the one I want to change, there's the one I want to change it to. Oh, hang on. I think, and this is where, when you have multiple texture... Oh, I know what I've done. I'm such a numpty. I always forget things like this. I did say a little while ago, I'm not firing all cylinders. Basically, I've used the same skin definition name for each definition, and I've plunked four textures on each. Which I don't believe I can do. So, let's start again. Oh. Alright. Man, this is going to be a lot of work. I'm just nuking what I did because I can't tell what I've done and what I haven't done. Basically, what I've realised I've done is I've overwritten the existing skin textures, hence why they've all changed like that. So now, if I go reload skins, it should put the things back. Yeah, there we go. Right, so rather than putting four textures in, let's just start again from scratch. Basically, I have to create a definition for each one. And retain all the variation on the front face as well. Right. I think in this instance, I'm just going to... Let's just see how many individual models there are. These are all the LOD modules. Right, so that's that one done. Spacer. Oh, I've already got that one in there, but I need to copy all the load. All the different names. Low, lowest. Okay. They're all the same. Oh, so there's not that many modules. The issue runs into, if they all had the same front texture on, this would be a piece of cake. I'd have done it by now. But the fact that they've all got multiple skins for the front face, this is what's complicating it. Just a little problem there with I'll have to come back to that later. I'll move this across that way a little bit. Right, where were we? Right, so there are all the roof modules. I could go through each of these skins, picking out which one has the so I'm thinking internally. Basically, how many skins have we got? I can probably get rid of the ones I don't need. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Ah, those ones though we don't need because there's no wood, there's no roof models in this, these skin definitions. Let me just double check that. Yeah, that doesn't have one. All right, not as many as I thought then. Right then. So start again. In fact, that one wasn't so good. The scale on it was a bit too big. So unfortunately, that's going to have to go. So we'll have four textures if we include the existing moss texture. So we're going to call this one Let's just give that a blast and see. What was that? Multicolor. So multicolor, I believe, is, where is it? That one. In fact, yeah, let's give it a blast. Hide there. What did I call my one? Interesting. That module isn't in the list. Man, I couldn't have chosen a more complicated one to bloody do, could I? As in creating skins that have to play nicely with existing skins. Medium, lowest. Oh, low, right, medium, low, lowest, okay. Come on. Lit. Why is it? Ah, there we go. But it's fucked about with the front face texture, which I didn't want it to do. And the textures are the wrong way around. Maybe this wasn't such a good idea. So basically, to get the texture the right way around, I would have to create a new texture. So it potentially means the existing texture is also the wrong way around on all the models. Fuck's sake. All right, how am I going to get around this? What is it that's breaking? It shouldn't have broken anything. There's the new one I've added, and the only thing it should have changed was the roof texture. That's it. It shouldn't have changed anything else. The other thing as well you'll notice is that some of the textures there, for example, oh, that's interesting. And if you haven't got word wrap on, and you don't want to have word wrap on when you're using a text editor like Notepad++, there is a space between that and the other texture, but it appears below it because obviously you only see that it's in the same line when you pull the editor window out a bit. Still doesn't explain what's breaking my try and put it above it. Nope, still breaks it. Another way around this, which would probably be simpler, would be to have... In fact, this might be a much simpler way. What I'm thinking is these models have face-only versions of them. So instead of using a model that uses the whole roof texture, roof section, it just has a face, and then what you do is you just have piece of wood, brushwork or patchwork along here, and then a patch there, and then a patch there to give you different roof textures. Doesn't explain why flipping skin is changing. Oh, I think I screwed up there. No, I'll come back to that later. Right now, I want to figure out why that's breaking the face texture. You know what? Just for expedience sake, I'm not going to bother doing this. It's just going to take way, way too long. So I think we'll go with the to create new textures for the spaces. Ah, it could be that that's got a model because it's a LOD texture. Where is it? Multicolor. There we go. Alright, let's start near the beginning of the map. That one can stay as it is, and let's do this one. So hopefully there's a LOD front face only for that. And there is. Happy days. Right, and that looks as close to that as possible. So now what I can do is it's only going to have a handful of spaces. I'm only changing one texture. Let's just see how many spaces there are. I created that one. I think I already created that one. Right, it's a new one as well. No, I think I definitely have created that one already. Yeah. Yeah, I don't think that's the man. That's that many spaces. Let's just see. Yeah, 128 spacer, 256 spacer. Is there a 384 spacer? No, there isn't. What I've done is I've just moved the model out into the void so that I can get a copy of all the different spaces. I thought I just could copy it from that other file, but clearly that was a mistake because there's way more. When you go looking for them. Oops. Oh, different kind of spaces. Oh, maybe there is any 3 or 4 roof spaces. Hmm. Oh, there isn't a 384 spacer. I'll have to log a ticket for Spring Hill then to create one. Right then, there's literally 2 spaces. Oh, well, that makes my job a lot easier. Oops. All right. The reason for doing that, by the way, is it's easier than trying to search going add. If you just type skin Choose the skin. Woohoo! Yeah, it looks like Spring Hill's put the texture the wrong way around on all of the models. It's because it now means all these skins are all going to be the wrong way. So the only way around this is I have to create new textures with this texture spun round the other way. Or I create my own spacers with the textures the right way. Alright, well, that's how you create skins. This video is now on 46 minutes. The wood one's broken. Sorry, just having some toast. All these skins was a complete waste of time because they're all flipped round. So now I'm going to have to do it the hard way around and create clones of the spacers. But let me make a note of that. So this is going to go from being a skin tutorial to how I've cloned a lot of Spring Hill's modules tutorial. This is going to be fun. Because a lot of his stuff is just off ever so slightly. So my modules will work in this instance here where we can change the face. But I don't know if that, depending on how well I manage to do them, they're not going to marry up too well. With the existing models. Right, so I've created a patch, a brush. I'm going to create an end cap. Let's add some, is it columns? No. Rows. No. It was columns. go. Like I say, it's not going to get, it's not going to match perfectly. And do you know what, for the purposes of this, I don't think there's much point doing that, because I can't tell which end is which. I'm going to look at it end on. As in, I can't tell from here how well it's going to line up, and as I'm only using it as a roof changer, it's unnecessarily complication. So let's remove there we go. What I'm doing is I'm making a brush of the right dimensions, and then I'm going to use that to create a face off of it. Like that. Hide there. One there. One there. Create. Hide it. Get rid of the brush. Right, there's the right way. Oh, there's a bit down the end. Did I have to do? Yeah, I forgot to do that. Okie dokie. Going to be easier to do the thing I did just a minute ago. Oh, another top tip. I think it was Goldwell that taught me this. If you're looking for a texture and you want to apply it to an existing, or you want to find it, you just select the surface, and it can't be done on a model, it can only be done on patches or brushwork. Select the face, middle mouse click on it, and it takes you to the texture in the textures inspector. Just group them for now. Oh, what that is. Ah, oh, that was the. control G-ing them to snap them to grid at the lowest possible grid. So mirror that. There we go. Is there anything else I need to copy? No, not really. Oh, I need to bend the the roofs in a bit. Sorry, these bits, the side bits. This way is to add a single division. There we go. That'll do. Let's get rid of the original model. Right, there's my new spacer module. I should just be able to adjust the existing one. Yeah, that'll do. However, there's a spacer under the bottom of this one. No, it's just the way the road thing's curving. Take a bit of artistic license here, I think. I think these are a bit straighter. Don't have to be perfectly straight, just straighter than what they are. Now Yep, those are completely out. No, 606. Yeah, just below at 606. There we go. All right, one spacer. So what I'm going to do is just copy and paste and then change the texture on the roof bit. Ground. Change the texture on this one over here because it's brushwork. Right, let's change that to face only. Oh, for God's sake, please tell me there's a face-only version of this module. No. LOD module is what I was referring to. No. Pointless having it as LOD if I can't flip and change it. Does it, what you can see I'm looking at there. Oh no, I'm getting away with it because of that spacer. Fine, I was worried that I could see a gap between the inner and the outer roof bits, but no, I can't. Seriously. Nice. Alright, let's see if there's a face-only version of this one. Right, as this we're up to an hour on this video, and you watch me faff about making mistakes, I think we'll call it an evening, but I think you get the general idea of how to create skins, etc. I'm going to go through now and replacing all the various different roof models to give some variation in the roof textures. And then I'll drop the map back to you this evening.